guys want to see my portable weather station? Because it's really amazing and all that.
You do?
Well, then come closer. Don't be shy. What we used to make the portable weather station was the IoT kit. And the components of the IoT kit were Microbit, IoT bit, BME280, the dust sensor, and the light sensor. So you guys already know what the Microbit and the IoT bit does. But the BME280 doesn't really make that much sense because it measures three things in one, to where it measures pressure, temperature, and humidity. And now let's open the IoT kit. Now let's open it. We got a manual that helps us out with everything. Then look at all of these components. So what the manual does is what it does to where it shows us all the components that are here, and it also tells us what they're called. And if we just flip to the later pages, it will also tell us how to do some stuff with it, to where it will tell us to do the coding in it. Do you guys remember the previous channel that I created on ThingSpeak from the previous video? And if you guys remember that, you guys will also know that I had one field chart which was measuring the temperature. Now if we just scroll down here, we got 2, 4, and 5 field charts waiting for us right here. Other than one, we added by 4, which then equals to 5. Yeah, math. Okay, so what else we added? We added pressure, humidity. Let me just scroll down. We still have temperature. Dust. Wait, let me just scroll down. And light. If you guys saw the previous video, you would know that whenever the temperature gets 30 degrees or above, it should send us an email. But maybe you're doing something and you can't really check your email. So that would be kind of annoying. So this time, whenever the temperature gets 25 degrees and above, we should receive a phone call. Yup, you heard me, a phone call. So now I'm gonna be putting my hand on the BME so the temperature rises up. Now it's time to wait. As you guys can see, I am receiving a phone call from FTTTT. Now if we accept this, accept, put the speaker on.
An event called microbit_temperature_alarm occurred on the Maker webhook service.
So it is saying that the temperature is 25 degrees and above, which is so cool how you now receive a phone call. Okay, let me just decline that. We no longer need the phone calls. We just received a phone call from FTTTT saying that the temperature is 25 degrees and above. And we can't only do that with the temperature. We can also do that with the light, dust, humidity, and pressure. Now you guys can test it out up close. As you guys can see, I just received a call from FTTTT. Now if we accept that, open that.
Hello. An event called microbit_temperature_alarm occurred on the Maker webhook service.
So it is saying that it's 25 degrees and above. Thank you. For those of you that have seen my previous video, you guys would know exactly what's gonna happen. But for those of you that have not, you're gonna be blown to bits. Pam, run, bam! So we're gonna be using three platforms: MakeCode, ThingSpeak, and FTTTT. So what MakeCode will be doing? To where, let me just close this so you guys can see better. To where, what MakeCode will be doing? It will be programming the Microbit from here. What the Microbit will be doing is sending data to ThingSpeak. And then ThingSpeak is going to collect and measure that data for pressure, humidity, temperature, dust, and light. And it's also going to keep a close eye on them. And whenever one of them gets over their limit, it's going to send it to FTTT. Now, there are two ways we can use FTTT. So, either we send it with the email or with the calling. Let's do the calling. So, we click on this. Or actually, better yet, why don't we just create one, which makes it much easier. So, if we click on create, if this... Let's do the web hooks. If this web hook, so if we click on this, then let's just call it code. Code cool. Yeah, code cool. Then if we do on create trigger, then that adds, we're gonna add that, and let's do the calls. We do VoIP calls, and then if we click this, and let's just call the event name. And let's call it the same exact thing, which is code cool. And then if we click on create action, we're just gonna continue this. And yeah, that's all we gotta do. The webhook will be receiving the data from ThingSpeak and will be doing the thing that you wanted to do, either send an email or just call the person. And that's really all you got to this. But I didn't show you the codes for make code. So if we go back here, okay guys, so I'm gonna be showing you guys the code. So if you guys can see this part, the small part, all it really does is just connect the internet. That's really all it does. So on the second part that's a bit longer, all it will be doing is basically just displaying the OLED and all the information and data. So right here is the OLED. I'm not sure if you guys can see it. Right here is the OLED. So it'll be displaying the information. Then if we go down, the real fun is gonna start to happen. If we just go here, then if we bazooski like that, then if we just scroll up like that. So in this code, this is going to be really important. So it will be connecting to ThingSpeak. Then you have to kind of put your API key, which you get from ThingSpeak, and it's really important. Then you can create all the fields. I created field 1, which is pressure, field 2, humidity, field 3, temperature, field 4, dust, field 5, light. Of course, you can make as much as you want. You just have to have the correct code for them. Then upload data to ThingSpeak. Okay guys, so the link here, I'm gonna be putting it down below in the description so you guys can easily do it. Now, let's hop to ThingSpeak. Dun, 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 dun. And again, we gotta create 3 things, which is the channel, you know what I'm talking about, then the React, then the thing HTTP. Then what you're gonna be doing in the channel is, if you just go down right here, you're gonna be doing the field charts that you already used from MakeCode for the pressure, humidity, temperature, dust, and then if we just scroll down right here, the light as well. And before we continue on, the first channel, it's only to display the data. It's only for you to like look at it, no action happening. So if you guys just want to look at it, you know all that stuff without acting on it, it's okay. You can just stop at the channel. So the channel is amazing for historical information. Second of all, ho, if you guys want to act on this, you guys are gonna need to go to apps, then to React. So if we click on the alarm, so what React is going to do, George, is going to be looking at the channel from the channel that you created, and it's going to see if any temperature is higher than the degree I chose, 25 degrees, it will send it to Think HTTP. So let's go and hop right there. Think HTTP, we click on the temperature alarm. This is what we called it. Of course, you don't have to call it the same exact thing. So what Think HTTP will do, it's where it's just going to be waiting until it gets a call from React. And whenever it gets a call from React, it's going to send another call to IFTTT. And then what IFTTTTT will do, it's either you can send a call or an email. And that's all you gotta do here. And of course, if you guys didn't really understand much, and if it was a bit confusing for you, I prepared a blog down below in the description for you guys to see and basically just get more information about it. And also, don't leave yet. If you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and if you guys don't want to miss out on any new videos, just hit that notification bell. And I guess I'll see you later. Pa-pam!